This is a little bit of Daniel's Dilemma, the backstory story of Daniel from Close Friends series. "Y'all found me," Daniel says calmly, staring down into his glass of bourbon, sitting across from me. "Why did I say yes? Is that truly how you feel about all of this?" I asked him with a certain calm confidence. "It isn't as though you are a vampire. It is a privilege to be chosen to become one of them, and not a vampire like Dracula. If they chose to go that route again," I tried to reassure him, chuckling slightly under my breath. "Privilege?" Shaking his head, he closes his eyes and inhales deeply. "It's a privilege to be a Jackson." He looks me straight in the eye. "Are you unhappy? Do you hate me that much?" I ask him, staring back into his eyes. I try desperately to control my emotions. It keeps me having an outburst. "Of course not, Sebastian," he replies in an outburst. He replies in an almost hushed voice, looking around the room to see if anyone was eavesdropping on our conversation. I bite down on my lower lip hard, a bad habit I picked up from Daniel. I bow my head and get up to leave. "Sebastian, wait. You know that's not what I meant. I love you," he tells me. Standing up, he places his glass down on the coffee table in front of me and allows it to stand behind me. "Oh, Daniel, it wasn't forced on you to become one of us. You were offered just like the rest of us. This was your decision. Maybe it wasn't your choice to become a Jackson, but that is just the way that it happened. The roll of the dice." Turning around to face him, I grab him by the shoulder. "This has been your life for the last 10 years. Why are you still struggling with this? And why have you never told me how you truly felt?" "I'm your temporary mate, yes. But I'm your first. We should be able to confide in each other." His eyes soften just a little as he looks at me. Then I start to see how shameful he now feels. I slowly let go of him and back away. He immediately grabs hold of me, wrapping his arms around my waist and resting his head on my chest sideways. "I'm sorry, Sebastian. I didn't mean to make you feel insignificant." He exhales slowly before continuing. "Of course, I know that for males it is a drop of the dye, but whether we are a drop neutron or a neutron, please do not be angry with me. I really do love you and care for you, and I know that you feel the same way about me." Lifting his head, a small smile appears on his face, his beautiful, peach-colored face. His short, curly locks fall backwards off his face as he looks up at me. Placing my hand to his head, I gently caress his hair and smile back with a small laugh. I can never stay angry at him for too long, and I cannot begin to understand how he feels. But I have a feeling that he is not the only Jefferson that this was. "Daniel, can we talk?" I hear a familiar voice call from behind me. I just stepped out of Sebastian's bedroom. I swear, why we have made it to each other. see that it's my solution. His expression is one of concern. It's obvious that he is one of the people that were in the family/meeting room that heard our conversation. Of course, my solution. What is it that you wish to discuss? I answer him, bowing slightly with one arm across my stomach and the other behind my back, like this routine for us butlers, including one of the masters or mistresses. Follow me to my office, he orders me, before turning around to head in the direction of his private office. All of the offices are served around the clock to keep others of our species from missing in and out anything and everything that takes place behind their doors. Upon entering his office, I ask him instantly if there is anything that he needs, such as a food or a drink. No, money. You like bourbon, don't you? He asks me, grabbing the glass container, fill it with bourbon, and pours it into two short square glasses. I nod passively. He walks over to me and hands me one of the glasses. It's just for me to take a seat in the back of the couch, a distance from his desk, while he sits in one of the two black leather chairs opposite the couch. It must be hard. To be a drumming team, it takes a lot of will. He speaks to me kindly, looking up and down. He comes down out of the large window to his left. I remember the first time that Armin entered me. I was still human amid transforming. He continued, looking down with a smirk on his face. Can you imagine how it felt? Agonizing. Yet unbearably pleasurable at the same time. No other drumming team has ever had to go through that. It was sweet torture, transformed in that manner. Being transformed in that manner. He laughs a little, and a pain look starts to form on his smooth, oddly porcelain face. Do you hate him for that? I ask him without thinking. Before I can catch myself, he replies swiftly, looking up at me. Just as much as I love him. He pauses, tipping his head to the side a little bit. But that same night, harmless touch, it put me at ease.